It's actually a little bit of video, so that looks great.
Okay.
Okay. You have the credits there.
I never thought that I would end up in choreography, but what I did know is that from an early age is that I really enjoyed working with people, and like the performing arts felt like the place that that could happen. Like it couldn't really happen in photography. It could in film, but I wasn't so interested in that, such a specific way of working, or like film. I'm very much in love with film, and I've been working with a photographer for 7 years, but there isn't a freedom that there is in, I would say, in performance or in dance, or in, I've never worked in theater, but I would think that there is. But if you're painting or you're writing, it's a very solo act, and dance has always given the freedom to collaborate with many different artists from many different disciplines. So, rosé porn. Rosé porn is an idea that I've actually been working on in my head and a little bit on a real level, meaning like that I've started a collaboration with the musician Victoria Chong last winter. And it was originally a project that I set up for myself after I left Berlin and did the masters and I came back to Canada. And it was a way of me dealing with how to work with all these people that I want to work with that are not near me. So how to continue working with people while they're not present. So I decided to pick like a handful of people that I really enjoy working with, and I decided that I wanted to write songs for them. So it was kind of like this ode. And then I also created these performative instruction manuals that went along with the song, these audio performance instruction manuals that they, in the end, that I would send to them, and then in the end they would send me a video back. What I plan to do at Dancemakers is like, I've invited Victoria in, and with the other artists, like with Simon, Amanda, Rob, and Ellen, I want that we create a practice where we make an album, and through the making of the album will come the dance or the choreography, but I don't know what it's gonna be. But we will all take turns writing songs, singing the songs, making the music, and that by the end of this research period, there will be an album which will have led us to what will be shown in the next season. So I'm half Greek and half Czech. I was born in Czechoslovakia, which is now the Czech Republic. I feel like I come from a very special family in the sense that both my parents made some pretty bold decisions politically. And so we had to leave, and the Red Cross brought my sister Christina and I here, and we also have another sister, Anna, who was born here. And I guess the biggest thing was that my mother, in the end, raised the three of us on her own, but she always wanted to make sure that her kids, like if they wanted to make art or if they wanted to go in that way, that she made sure that we could do that, as opposed to like going for any kind of security, because I didn't grow up in a privileged environment, but I did grow up in a very culturally rich environment. And actually it's interesting because I grew up with so many artists around me. My mother always made sure that we always went back to Greece, and we weren't allowed back in the Czech Republic for 10 years because my parents went against the communists. And after that, and then when I was in my late 20s, I went and I lived in Prague and stuff, but I just saw that the people who had actually like made any kind of change in this world or any that did anything kind of political or interesting were these incredible artists. We have that opportunity and responsibility to be to go beyond just making a show